Cross-border collaboration and history among Nordic students, a case study about creating innovative ICT deductive models. My name is Maria Spante and I'm from University West Trollhättan, Sweden. My co-writers and colleagues are Asgerd Via Carlsen, Vestfold University Norway, Anne-Mette Nordvig and René B. Christiansen, University College Sjælland, Denmark. Overview of presentation. I will first present the overall project, then the aim of the paper. I will give you the timeline of GNU activities in history, its actions and progression, then an analysis of two major IT didactic models that the teachers and students used during the phase, and then conclusions in relation to these models, and sum up with some general conclusions for the next step in the GNU project. The GNU project. The GNU project is an EU-founded project related to cross-border collaboration for educational purposes, supported by information and communication technologies between Danish, Norwegian and Swedish schools. 18 classes from 13 different schools in phase 1 between 2011 and 2012 have participated, involving 29 teachers and more than 600 students. The aim of the project is to develop innovative cross-border teaching models by the means of user-driven, practice-based co-design processes between practitioners and researchers. Aim. This paper provides an in-depth description and analysis of how four social science teachers and their 70 students, 5th to 7th graders, worked together between November in 2011 until December in 2012. Previous research regarding use of ICT in history education in primary schools is limited, thus calling for contemporary investigation in this particular subject domain. The TPEC model, enhancing the combination of teachers' pedagogical, content and technological competences, was used as an analytical framework together with nation-specific curriculums and EU recommendations regarding student skills for lifelong learning. Timeline of GNU activities in history. The first step in the GNU project was a GNU kickoff, where all the involved teachers and researchers met in order to have a discussion of what to do with the students in the common time period. The history teachers decided that they should have a school presentation in the form of videos on a mutual blog. Here we see the school presentation video made by the students shared on the mutual blog. Each school from Denmark, Sweden and Norway had an individual school presentation that was distributed on the GNU history blog. What they found out in this phase of the project with this activity was it was hard to understand each other's spoken languages on the video when subtitle is missing. The next activity they planned for the students to do was videos about local history using a two-nation exchange model in an asynchronous setting. Videos about local history using a two-nation exchange model in an asynchronous setting. In this phase of the project, the students in Denmark prepared questions for Swedish students to work with and then answer in the form of videos. Swedish students made questions for the Norwegian students and that they should answer and send make videos of. And in addition, Norwegian students should send questions to the Danish students that would make videos with their answers. All these videos were then presented on the mutual blog. Here we see videos about local history using a two-nation exchange model in an asynchronous setting. Here we see pictures from the Swedish students working with questions from Denmark preparing for video production. And we also see examples of Danish student video based on questions coming from Norway. All this material is presented and shared on the Mutual GNU History blog. In this phase, they did work actively to combine text, voice, and pictures in order to improve the possibility to understand each other's production. However, in this phase, the students said to the teachers that they really wanted more real-time interaction with all three nations. So, in order to try to meet that demand from the students, the teachers worked actively with the nation curriculum in history in Denmark, Sweden, and Norway, looking specifically at the curriculums, discussed vividly what to focus on next, finding out different themes to work with, had a list of choices by which they specifically chose children's life condition during the 20th century. The aim this time was to work more actively with cross-border collaboration, creating nation-mixed teams and real-time meetings in Adobe Connect. To give the students an idea what they should work and focus on, the teacher presents material on the blog inspired by the flipped classroom model. Here we see 3 or 4 teachers sharing their pre-prepared material on the mutual blog in the spirit of flipped classroom. In order to create structure and focus on content, the 20th century became divided into 3 periods, in the beginning of 1900s, in the middle, and in the end, the year 2000. Here we can see examples of how it looked like when they used the Adobe Connect real-time meeting, when they prepared for and performed Adobe Connect actions. We see pictures from the day that they were preparing for the meeting of their respective Danish and Norwegian partners in the Adobe Connect meeting. We also see students leaning in front of their computer having the Adobe Connect meeting, connecting. And the third picture, we see a snapshot from the Adobe Connect system where we have examples of Danish, Norwegian and Swedish students talking in video conferencing, also sharing written content on the whiteboard. However, the students this time in the first real-time setup had prepared to share information in the Adobe Connect systems, but problem appeared. The Danish students, they talked about their school day as it is today, while Norway and Sweden talk about what school was like during their assigned time period. Here it was clearly a misunderstanding among the teachers on what to do in this first Adobe Connect meeting. So they did yet another try. The students met in Adobe Connect in their respective class match group to talk about their assigned time period. This time they did so. However, they do struggle a lot with sound problems and information-rich PowerPoint that is hard for them to share in the system, as well as making sense of, also having difficulties to understand each other's spoken languages. So, a third time is planned for, and the students meet in Adobe Connect in their respective class match group to sum up their assignment about their assigned time period. The students, they do finish their assignments, some quicker than others, seemingly quite disillusioned, still wishing each other Merry Christmas joyfully. Teachers will continue to participate in the GNU project next term as well. What they found out in this activity was that real-time collaboration was too complex for this task. New insight will therefore lead to new setup in the next phase of the GNU project. IT didactical challenges in history, looking specifically at the asynchronous model. If we then try to analyze what did happen in the two IT models used in the GNU project in history so far, we can see in relation to technological knowledge that they use blogs, digital cameras, and they were able to mix videos. In relation to pedagogical knowledge, we could see that they arrange for group work in class. The students were encouraged to make their own production. They were also encouraged to produce questions for others to work with. Students were in this model highly involved and engaged in their tasks. However, in relation to content, the content was not really focused upon. It was not followed up or discussed in the videos. We can see then, in relation to technological knowledge and pedagogical knowledge, the teachers in the three nations scored high in these two aspects. However, in relation to content knowledge, it was difficult to have something to say about that since it was not really addressed. Looking at IT didactical challenges in history in relation to the synchronous model. Looking at technological knowledge, we can see that using Adobe Connect was truly difficult. We could detect lack of usage competence that was hard to predict and train for. Looking at pedagogical competence knowledge, group work was conducted in class as well as in the cross-border setting, mixing Norwegian, Swedish and Danish students together. They did their own research, the students were highly involved, the students were also engaged in the beginning, but engagement did fade over time. Content knowledge were addressed. The teachers found a focus based in the national curriculums, and they really made an effort to grasp the specific content. Looking specifically at the aspect of the TPAC model here, we can say that the teachers scored high in relation to pedagogical knowledge and content knowledge. However, missing out in relation to the technological knowledge linked to this specific system of Adobe Connect. If we compare and contrast the two models, we can see that there are room for improvements. In the asynchronic IT didactic model, we can see that there should be more focus upon the content. And in the synchronous IT didactic model, we can see the necessity of focus more on the technological knowledge. Conclusion so, asynchronous model. Since video production became in focus, students need teachers' guidance to implement content into their productions. When productions are made and shared, the historical content need to really be discussed and analyzed in order to support learning. Since students seem eager to have real-time communication, the asynchronous model need to be clearly argued for and motivated as a cross-border collaboration model. Since it was hard to understand each other's spoken languages, it is good for the communication and future collaboration to use text in combination with voice in video productions. Conclusions in relation to the synchronous model. Tasks that should be dealt with in a synchronous setup needs strict preparation and sharp limitations in order to give added value to the learning situation for complex historical tasks. When language difficulties are present, the strict and planned session becomes even more essential. When groups or students are involved, the number of students should preferably be quite limited, perhaps just two students on each side to support cross-border team spirit. If the above-mentioned strict organization is hard to achieve, then the complexity of what should be dealt with during the real-time session needs to be reduced to a very simple task. It is also essential that all involved users are familiar with the digital technology used for communication and collaboration. So, general conclusion then. What we can see is intersection in the TPEC model is hard to address, but the difficulties need to be dealt with. It becomes additionally hard in a cross-border setting, thus requiring more time and effort. Cross-border collaboration provided added value thanks to the obstacles. Hurdles enhance the necessity to collaborate and communicate, thus creating a need as well as a push for teachers' professional development for the new demands from a digitalized society. Notwithstanding difficulties, it becomes highly important to work actively with the obstacles that emerges, to actively enhance the obstacles as a learning situation, since we can also see how these obstacles reveals differences that make learning about the other possible in a more rich and real situation compared to reading about these differences in textbooks or other types of material used for learning purposes in history classes. Thank you.